Freightquote has become a moving target after the Lenexa company announced it's moving its headquarters and 1,200 jobs to Kansas City, Missouri. In doing so, the company will receive $64 million in tax incentives over 23 years. This move flies in the face of recent efforts to stop the so-called poaching of companies and jobs from one side of the state line to the other. Critics say it produces no net gain for the metro area. One local commentator has actually called the Freightquote deal a fiscally insane taxpayer giveaway. Who might that have been? Yale.
Well, we've been having so much fun today talking about politics that it's going to be hard for me to get outraged, but let me try. This whole poaching issue, I think, is really has. The good thing is it's captured the public's attention, finally. I mean, after 2 decades of writing about this, people kind of get TIF now. They understand these tax breaks, and they really understand that it makes almost no sense in this metropolitan area for somebody to leave Lenexa and go 8 or 12 miles over to Kansas City and get millions of dollars in taxpayer money from the state and from the city for simply building a corporate headquarters there, or for AMC to go from downtown Kansas City to wherever the heck they went, Leawood, vice versa. So, I think people's general outrage at it is going to help drive public policy eventually with some mayors, like Mayor Sly James, who understands it very well, participates in it, as well as some other mayors that I think they're getting it and putting pressure on the governors. Yes, sir.
Well, I was going to ask you, if it's all bad, why is it done and done so often?
Well,
Doesn't anybody benefit?
It's not all bad. The private companies benefit from it. So you get some people who are going to pay some earnings tax dollars to Kansas City. They come over here. Now, of course, there are deals. We're going to give away some earnings tax money right back to them. But the city still benefits, I was told today, like $500,000 a year. Oh, great. Well, we would have gotten $1 million a year if we wouldn't have given them an incentive. Now, they might not have come, or they might have come anyway.
I think it's important to point out that the civic leaders in Kansas City have, and I believe it was last March, come together. Mr. Hall, the Hall Family Foundation, wrote a letter to political leaders on both sides of the state line saying, hey, stop this madness. This can't go on. We're eroding the tax base. The first time I ever got involved, Yale, in Kansas City grassroots organizing was to stop a 353 on the plaza called the Sailors Project. Yeah. And we succeeded, sort of. But it's done. It's over. This is the way business is done now.
No, it's not. No, it is not.
I disagree. It is.
You and Steve Rose are absolutely wrong when
you say, I'm not going to take his position.
Oh, you're not going to.
Let me have my own views here. He's also wrong. We can't. It could be stopped, but Mr. Hall would have to organize, find some political candidates who agree with him.
When you say Mr. Hall, are you talking about Bill Hall?
Bill Hall, yes.
Okay.
Find some political candidates willing to run for office and stop this thing, because Brownback and Nixon are not going to do it, nor should Sly James do it.
Okay, now Steve Rose, the aforementioned Steve Rose, has written that if a moratorium in Greater Kansas City came to pass, businesses would be courted by cities elsewhere,
they
would move anyway.
I don't agree with that either. I think the issue here is one of the impact versus the intent of all of these incentives. Typically, in the past, they were designed to try to attract businesses to this area from Philadelphia or somewhere, bring somebody here to Kansas City, to the region. And what should be happening is more of a regional collaboration on bringing business to the region, because both sides of the state benefit here. You know, people are going to live in Johnson County. They're going to live in Kansas City. They're going to take part in the entertainment and all that the region has to offer. And we have failed miserably at coming to closure on some type of one Kansas City, but we haven't been able to achieve
that. In about 5 to 7 seconds, Steve, are you upset by this as a Johnson Countyan?
I'm not upset as a Johnson Countyan. I just think it's bad policy. I don't want to see legislation to stop it. I just don't like it for the same reasons that Yale and Gwen just mentioned. I don't think it's a net gain for the city, because they give up all these tax breaks. These people, these aren't new jobs coming to Kansas City.
Right.
These people still live in Johnson County.
We're clearly past 7 seconds.